Yo, we are having mad fun in the building today.
I'll be damned.
Yo, shout out to y'all. We hope y'all are having as much fun as we are having. And it can only go up from here now that we have entered this special part of the show, Wreck and Review, where we talk about music and art that touches us or moves the needle, moves the culture. This week, I'm very, very excited to be talking about Black Odyssey, Diamonds and Freaks, with the biggest Black Odyssey fan that I know, Sway. Set the stage for us.
The year is 2020. Right? There's a group out of Austin that drops a tape called Black Vintage out of nowhere.
Black Vintage sounds like your whole style.
That's right for now, you. Bro. My style right now.
That's aimed at you.
That's my style right now. But when Black Vintage dropped, I speak about this so many times when it comes to music, Miles, is that there's a certain feeling you get when something that you've never heard or something fresh comes along and it sounds nothing like what's conventional and what's out there, right? So Black Odyssey is an artist from Austin, Texas. And the way I like to describe Black Odyssey is to say, Black Odyssey is who you think is cool. The person that you think is cool finds somebody else cool, and that's the music that they're listening to. This is the music that your cool person is listening to, man. And I only say that because it is so avant-garde, and it's very avant-garde in its delivery. It's hip-hop, jazz, R&B, soul fusion, done in a way that we've really only really seen with Anderson .Paak's Malibu, which was an incredible album, and Black Odyssey did the same thing with Black Vintage. And so going into Diamonds and Freaks, their second album, or his second album with his band, we were worried that it would be the same thing that Anderson .Paak had on his second album, where we lost a lot of what made it fresh and original and exciting. Dissipated a bit, it dissipated. Some people say he's never been able to regain it on a solo album again, but that's Anderson. When we come to Black Vintage, they knocked the second album out of the park. This to me is currently my favorite music out right now.
I ain't mad at that one bit. And I was very interested to hear if you felt mad differently about this project than you did about Black Vintage. Because for a while, man, Black Vintage was that joint. You know when somebody recommends you somebody you trust, somebody you believe in, you know, their recommendations be on point, you know, their playlist be fire, you know what I'm saying? They know they art. When somebody makes a recommendation, a strong recommendation, with that place of respect, you want to honor that recommendation, you want to check it out, you want to give that music a real chance. Multiple times I tried to get into Black Vintage and it just didn't quite click.
Really? Really?
Yeah, the first few times I listened to the album, it was nothing bad to say about it, but it just didn't. I didn't feel the thing that I felt you trying to share with me. You feel me?
Okay. Because the whole time we're together, that's might have been all I was listening to in 2022.
Yeah, and maybe like just because I was mostly hearing it, like, you know, because you would be taking showers and this would be bumping and I would be hearing, like, it was that type of vibe. I'm like, okay, it's a little bit, I couldn't find my setting for it. This album right here didn't matter. Did not matter where I played it. It was that.
Yeah.
Effortlessly, undeniably. The artistic focus, the respect for all of the genres and all of the previous artists that he's drawing from, this clicked immediately for me. And to the point where I went back to Black Vintage and it made that album sound different in my ears. Because whatever it is, I got it. I understood it now. And it reminds me of the best of Anderson .Paak, the best of Masego, the best of Goldlink. I hear a lot of Kendrick in this album. Not even so much with the in the middle of the songs, but the transitions and the snippets and the skits, the way he constructed this body of work to reflect voices inside and outside of musical efforts. Like, this was a real piece of art, and I mess with it a lot.
It is such a great piece of work, man. And one of the things that makes it very tapped in and very now is the fact that it's the people who have featured on this album. One of our absolute favorite artists who always goes under the radar that's featured quite heavily in this is Rhapsody. And Rhapsody plays this kind of alter ego throughout this whole album, kind of being the female voice in it, but in a very new way. You know, a lot of the times when we're listening to hip-hop album or when we're listening to these sorts of albums, the female voice is one that is submissive or is one that doesn't necessarily have a voice. Is they're just there to kind of take the role of it's an expected female voice, right? But to have such a prominent female voice featured throughout all of these songs and how they're speaking is so honest and direct and it balances out. And then you got Baby Rose that's featured on here as well, who's also just so incredible. Then you got Keisha Plum, who does a lot of the spoken poetry that goes throughout this whole album. It is so brilliant, man. It is so brilliant. It really transcends genre. It's hard to be able to categorize this into a single genre and say what it is. The artwork is phenomenal. The music video is out of this world. It is all so well put together, and I think these guys are really a force to reckon with. I would love to get a collab. I've got it. Give me out.
Give it to us.
I've been thinking about this. A Black Odyssey Isaiah Rashad collaborative album.
I like that. That would be really interesting because Zay for sure can take it to that artistic place. He can paint with an abstract brush sonically. So that would be really interesting. Part of me wants more rappity rap from Zay. So that would be my only hesitation. But nah, I can only imagine that would sound fantastic. The features on this, the collaborations on this album are well placed and well used. I hope some young people go check out Bootsy Collins, get real funky with his past discography. Emerald Soul is somebody that I just recently started following that I think is, she's going to be up there. She's going to be mentioned with the Georgia Smiths and the Cleo Souls. It's coming. So I was really glad to see her there. And I was glad to see that some of the features from Black Vintage carried over. It seems like he's got a collaborative and a collective of people that he likes to work with. And that chemistry is super apparent on this joint. I was sucked in immediately from Dopamine and Hennessy. Miss Sweet Tea was one of my favorite joints on there. Summer in the Rain is dope. It slowed down a little bit for me towards the middle, but then picked back up with that Diamonds and Freaks. Broke Folk Funk, Let Me Go, some of my highlights, man.
Such a good album, man, and I cannot just like be so proud of this music. You know, you hear about the talent that's in Austin, and this is such a great exemplary piece of work for that type of talent, man. This dude is so talented, and if you haven't seen the music videos, it's so layered and so deep. Undoubtedly, when I'm walking through an art gallery or when I'm exploring life outside of the comforts of what I know, when I'm exploring a new city, exploring a new space, just navigating through the world looking cool, this is the type of music that I'm listening to. I'm undoubtedly listening to Black Odyssey. Miss Sweet Tea is great. Summer in the Rain is incredible. The middle part that you speak of, those are the singles that came out. So I'd already rinsed them when they came on, but I was a big fan of Honeysuckle and Neckbone, You Got a Man, OD, Diamonds and Freaks, Judas and the Holy Mother. The whole thing for me slaps. Is it better than the first? I can't say that quite yet. However, what I can say is that This album for me is incredible. It gets a 4.5 out of 5.
I love that. I love that. 4.5 is exactly where I was at too. It felt like the expression was there. I really felt the artist come through in the content and in the sound. I think because it was so beautiful and artistic, I think I would have liked a little bit more of a personal touch, if that makes sense. You know what I mean? Just getting a little bit deeper into who this artist is, you know, a little bit more of their story, I think would have been nice. But sonically, I got nothing bad to say about this, man. This is a vibe. It's versatile. I'm gonna have this playing in the whip. I'm gonna have this playing while studying and working. I'm gonna have this giving me life all throughout the background. And shout out to you, man. The first place you thought of when you thought of where you be at was walking through art galleries looking cool. And I love that for you, you know?
I take it very seriously.
Yeah. It works for you. It works for you. You embody it, you know?
I appreciate that, brother. I appreciate it. And one thing that we embody is the love that we give from everybody who's tuning into this on a weekly basis, man. We know.
Oh, yeah, man. We know. Y'all could be anywhere in the world. Y'all are all over the world doing all sorts of dope things, from individual impact projects to creating and curating art to just being family with us and with y'all's people. And we appreciate you taking time away from each and every one of those things to listen to us, to rock with us, to be a part of the show. We had a lot of laughs in this one, man. We had a really good time today. This space is so important to me. This is a celebration of celebrating. It's a celebration of life. It's a celebration of how good it feels to have new Black Odyssey music out. Don't it feel good, Zway?
Love it. Absolutely love it.
No doubt, man. If y'all looking for something to listen to, run to this. If you're looking for something to watch, check out Rye Lane, Black British film. Little romantic joint, throw that on with your lady. Highly recommend that. Check that out. And that's what we got for y'all this week, man. We hope that y'all eat something delicious. We hope that you hug somebody you love like that. Peace, water, we out of here.